What a beautiful day it is today. Toronto, Detroit, two beautiful cities with two amazing hockey teams. It was on July 30th, 1903 in Toronto, Ontario, when the birds were chirping and school was out, and a baby that went by the name of Harold Ballard was born. Both Ballard's parents were born but not raised in England, and they immigrated to Canada at a young age. His father, Sid Ballard, moved from Toronto to New York to Pennsylvania and back to Toronto to start up his own business. That business sold ice skates and other hockey equipment to the Toronto garment industry. At age 16, Harold Ballard ended up dropping out of school in his third year to help run his father's business, and in 1935 it was given to him 1 year before his father passed, and it was successfully ran until the 1970s. Now on this end, in Detroit, Michigan, on July 20th, 1929, Mike Ilitch, the son of two Macedonian immigrants, was born. Once he graduated high school, he was offered a contract from the MLB's very own Detroit Tigers with a signing bonus of $5,000, but he ended up turning down the offers to join the Marines and serve his country from 1948 to 1952, where he played baseball on the military base. When he finished serving his duty, he signed a 3-year deal with the Tigers and spent the majority of that time in the farm system. A day that would change the course of Detroit sports history and the history of the Ilitch family is 1959 May 8th. The iconic pizza franchise Little Caesars that was founded by Mike and Marion Ilitch was created, and it gave them the ability in 1982 to buy the historic NHL franchise, the Detroit Red Wings, and the Fox Theater in downtown Detroit. Harold Ballard became the part owner of the Toronto Maple Leafs in 1961, and the team was thriving, making it three consecutive Stanley Cup Finals from 61 to 63, and won once more in 67. Ballard and the second majority owner in 1969 went to jail for tax fraud because they were using the team's funds for personal use. Him and his business partner were each sentenced 3 years to jail, and during this time, his partner died in a slander. So, Ballard became the Toronto Maple Leafs' sole majority owner. He got out of jail, only serving a year and a half of his 3-year sentence on good behavior, and after this, it only got worse for the Leafs. Once he got out, he had full control of the team, and he had some changes to make. In 1971, the WHA, or the World Hockey Association, was founded, and just like everyone else, Ballard didn't think anything of it. It was just a small, worse, and crappier league than the NHL. Well, it was good at competing. And frankly, it was upsetting. When the Leafs would develop, find, and get good players, it was great. The team did well, and the fans came to the stands. Now, every player wants to be paid their fair share of what they're doing for the team, but Harold Ballard would never pay his players. They wanted more money, and almost without fail, they went to the WHA or traded to other NHL teams. Their best players would leave because of how the team is never built around them, and they never made a core, or because of the terrible locker room and team environment. But the reason Ballard continued to get away with this is the fans never stopped buying tickets. They never did. Even when the team's at some of its lowest, trading away its stars just because, or having them walk away in free agency, they still came to watch Maple Leafs hockey. Not sound biased or anything, but Mike Ilitch's story sounds a bit better. Now, Mike Ilitch bought the Detroit Red Wings at the time when no one wanted them. They sucked. So he got them for a grand total of $8 million in 1982. They are now worth $1.03 billion, and the team came with a brand spanking new arena too. They were initially lied about the total number of season ticket holders, so what they had to do was very smart. They got a hold of their Little Caesars franchise owners in the Michigan and Detroit area and tried to sell them season tickets. How smart is that? Now the team was in a bad spot. They were being deemed as the Dead Wings because of how poorly they were doing, and Mike Ilitch was there to change that. It was quoted by someone, a fan, that in some nights in the arena, you could shoot a cannon into the stands and not hit someone. It was bad. The team was bad, the attendance was bad, and the coaches and GMs, they just went in and out like no one's business. It became a culture where the coaches and GMs they're going in and out like a revolving door, and the first step was to create some consistency with the team. Step number two came with Mike Ilitch's first draft in 1983, when he drafted a man that goes by the name of Steve Eiserman in the number four slot.
Well, obviously you're going to have more of the quick changes on these lines here as we go into this second overtime. Gretzky had it, lost it, Eiserman picks it up. Eiserman moving, blue line, chance, score! Steve Eiserman! Detroit wins!
Well, under the control of Harold Ballard, it's a bit unfair for me and biased of me to say that the team was inconsistent and bad, but for the most part, it's kind of true. It was like a roller coaster of time for the Leafs franchise between the dates of 70 and 91. It was also like a crappy money ball, but the players, they want more money, so they had traded for worse talent, but more of them. It never ended up working in their favor. Their prospect pool was so small, when they get a kid and finally have the chance to play, it's either you're good or you're not, you're a bust or you go somewhere else. It's really a shame. They had some good bursts of the team. Like in 1993, they went and made it to the Western Conference Finals, but Harold Ballard did die in 1990. The team was no good, they had no good future, no prospects, and they're meh, they're all over the place. But as long as the seats were being filled, Harold Ballard was happy. Have you ever watched some new U-turn? It's awesome, it's kinda cool, they're just turning it all around. And that's what Mike Ilitch was able to do. Day one, he started to turn that franchise around by drafting Hall of Famers like Steve Eiserman, Nicholas Lidstrom, and others like him, and pumping a very generous amount of money into the franchise. Because of the low attendance, he used his Little Caesars business as a promotional way to get fans in the stands. And at any and all home games for the first year or so, he would give away a car, and when you only have 5,000 people in the stands, your odds are pretty good. Mike Ilitch took the time, hired the right people, and with no time, the correct drafting and player development, and the up-and-coming Steve Eiserman, the team was set for success. In 1993, the Wings hired the all-time most winningest coach, Scotty Bowman, to lead the helm. Because of the culture in the locker room, and a bit of Scotty Bowman, including the belief of Mike Ilitch, the team went on a 25-year playoff streak, going from 1991 to 2016. They made it to 6 Stanley Cup Finals, winning 4 of them in 97, 98, 02, and 08. And in 08, 09, they made the back-to-back Cup Finals against the same opponent, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Some people, over time, they change into better people and improve themselves. You know, they grow, then they change. Not Ballard. This man was special, to say the least. To keep the cost down of the team, he had a very, very minimal front office. 3 scouts, and he was the GM and owner, so he could make the decisions entirely based off bias and money to get his way. This man here, Harold Ballard, fired the man who pushed his wheelchair when he was on the brink of death. You tell me, what kind of a man does that? Who is he? What kind of a man does that? Mike Ilitch, otherwise known as Mr. I, in the city of Detroit was a man of spending. Not on himself, though. He spent his money on sports teams and in the city of Detroit. Quoted by Kent Holland, the old GM of the Detroit Red Wings, he enjoyed seeing his team do well, transforming the Red Wings and the Detroit Tigers into championship teams that are heavy favorites to win was such an important thing to him. Investing in good management and leadership, you can see how much he cares about the teams in the city of Detroit. End quote. All he cared about was putting a good team together to win. And winning for the city of Detroit in America helped the team win by investing talent on the ice or on the diamond or in the office. All he wanted was to see the best for his teams in the city of Detroit. He treated his employees like families. He generated Detroit. He made a culture of giving. Hell, who doesn't remember in 08 when Detroit was in the middle of a recession when the whole US was? And frankly, Detroit is a blue-collar dominated city, and well, the hockey tickets, the price is too high, and the culture of that locker room paid off. What the players did is, on the Red Wings, they banded together and they lowered their pay grade and their salary so that Mike Ilitch would lower the price of the tickets. They did this for the fans.
Fancy skating there, and then it's dealt back ahead. Here's Phil.
Yeah, this pick is about to kick off this point. It's Wes. Let's take it back to straight hit pop and start it from scratch. I'm about to bloody just jack up. Everybody get back. That's why my pin needs a pad, because my rhyme's on a red tag. It's like I did with a dick, and I'm about to freak it. Like a magician, critics, I turn to freak it. Got them still on the fence, whether to freak it. But quick to get impaled when I tell them freak it. So sick from looking pale, well, that's my freak it. About to go ahead. Now this is time to freak it. Let's bring it back to the bench and slim dance. The only NC in mix with the Vin Chicken and NC Rin. And I don't mean Stimpy Spring Dance. Been public enemy since you jumped me. Was Jim Dash.
Khakis pressed, Nike shoes crispy and fresh lace. So I guess it ain't that aftershave of cologne that made him just faint. Plus I show up with a coat, fresh and wet paint. Sweet love is a chess game, checkmate. Girl, your body's banging, jump me in, bang, bang, bang. Yes sir, we bop, I was thinking the same thing. So come get on this kid's rock, bop with the bop, dang, dang. Both so smart enough to feel stupid. Hope so, now hope.
Kick shoes off, let your head out.
All night long.
Pull your beard out, just beard out.
All night long. We're gonna rock this house until we knock it down. So turn the volume loud. Cause it's been to the haters. So break the pace up like crazy. Let yourself go, let yourself go. I say forget before we kick the bucket. Life's too short tonight.